This is a Plymouth State University ceramics program demonstration video regarding using a slab roller, making a slab and compacting the surface, and making a cylinder. If you have any questions, you can contact me at the email listed on the screen. Have a good one. So what we've got here is a great big industrial slab roller. And what you're gonna do is you're gonna take a piece of newspaper, all right? You're gonna put it down, and you are gonna wanna make a big long slab. To make a big long slab, you notice the shape of the clay that I have here. All right. When I put this on the slab roller, I don't want to put it like that so that it's lengthwise parallel. I want to put it so that it is like that. So what I'm going to do is I've got the clay in here. I've got this piece of newspaper. The newspaper is so that you don't get the clay stuck to the canvas, because this area is going to get all wet and damp. The clay will stick. So I take the canvas, all right, and I make sure that it doesn't get double wrapped underneath here. And by that I mean I don't just go like, oh, I'm just gonna slab roll that. That's a bad idea. So I take the canvas, I kind of hold it up, and I start steering the ship into a position like that. And then when I pull it back, I just kind of pull on the canvas. And I can spin this wheel. You don't want to do this at 100 miles an hour. This is an old machine. Okay? And you'll notice that the slab has kind of gone out long like that. Now, if I want to make the slab a little bit thinner, which I'm going to, I'm going to double up the canvas. Makes it a little bit thinner, right? And when I have the newspaper, it allows me to pick this up and move it around a little bit easier, right? It doesn't stick to the canvas. All right, now we're gonna go over to this table. The next thing we wanna make sure that we're doing is that we are compacting the surface of the clay. So I'm gonna wanna compact the surface of the clay. I'm going to do that using my metal rib. When I compact the surface of the clay, I give it a little spray, just one or two, and then I compact the surface of this slab. In doing that, it's going to make it so that it bends when I put it into a shape. Notice I'm doing it in a few different directions. All right. I've done it on one side, I flip it over. And I do the other side. And actually, I can give you an example here. If I flip this and I start to bend it, you see how it cracks a little bit, but not too much. If I do it on the other side, it's really gonna crack, all right? So, I'm on the side that I didn't compact. Cut this slab, you'll see that it's about this thick, which is about maybe a quarter of an inch or so. If I want to make this even thinner, which I do, take off my scraps of clay here. And what I'm establishing right now is how tall my cylinder is going to be. What I can do with the slab now is I can do what's called throwing the slab. In throwing the slab, it is not across the room. I am going like this. And it's gonna torque the slab a little bit. You'll notice that there's some cracks that are happening on this. So I'm gonna recompact the surface. A lot of cracking. Sometimes you just want to remake the slab. But just in doing that, I've added about another 2 inches to this slab. Making a cylinder, I can take lots of different cylindrical objects, wrap some newspaper around them, this I don't really need to explain to you. I think you're going to figure it out. So I cut that slab. I slip and score my seam. And this is where the fork comes in handy. Because it's going to take me this much time. It's going to take you a lot less if you have a fork. So I overlap it like that. Viola. I've got a cylinder. To go to that seam, and I'm gonna compact that seam. Whenever you are compacting at this point, you don't have the table to give resistance on the other side, so I'm gonna put my hand on the other side. And I'm gonna do that on the inside and the outside. Now this has no form to it right now. It can go oval, I can make any what kind of shape I'd like to. But what we're gonna do is take a pinch pot, and with small pieces of clay like this, you don't have to try, like I always like seeing someone who's doing trying to wedge, like you know, it's like that doesn't work, you know. So you just take the clay and you can do kind of a hand wedge, and that's just taking the clay, kind of folding it over. Kind of getting those air bubbles out of it. So what you're going to do with these is you're going to, because what's the easiest way to make a bottom for this?
Roll.
So you just roll out another flat slab, right? And you just plop it on there, and that's definitely a solution. But for this one, we're going to make a pinch pot. And the best way to do this is to do it in your hands, right? Now I'm pinching this out as I go around, and I'm going to kind of custom fit this.
If you don't have enough, do you have to start over again?
You might want it, yep, okay. Or you can just make it thinner, you know? You don't want it to be too thin. On there. And what you want to do is I would make your cylinders first, one and two. You're going to have two, and they have to relate some way when we get around to it. And then make two pinch pots. And you can connect them now. And what I would do is I need to level this lip off a little bit. So I can do that by oh, it's a little bit too small. Clay is flexible. So I can go around the lip of this. Pinch that in a little bit. Slip and score. Put this on, and then you have the beginnings of a rather large mug. Okay. So these are going to be rather large mugs. We're going to put a handle on these. We're going to put a little foot on them. And away you go. Okay. So these are thick. So if you look at this, this is kind of thick. That's okay when you're first starting out. Thick is just durable. Okay. So we're looking for two of those. All right.